At the Seder every Passover, we remind ourselves that we are still in Egypt, that all of us are still slaves. This is what we educators like to call cognitive dissonance. Compared with so many of those who came before us, so many of us are in a period of unrivaled affluence, liberty, education, peace. If we are still slaves in Egypt, we are certainly well-fed and prosperous ones. The Torah teaches us that during moments when our bellies are full, we are tempted to believe that our success is solely the result of our own efforts. It is true that we have worked hard to achieve our wisdom, our strength, and our wealth, yet it is easy for us to forget that most of our achievements are attained only because of the work and the sacrifice of many others, mainly those who never had the opportunities that we have. In times of prosperity, the Torah teaches us that we must express our gratitude for our good fortune. We must pause to reflect that we will only be truly free when all people are free. And most importantly, we must plan for the inevitable hard times ahead on the journey to the true promised land. But how? The challenge for all of us as we look to the future is in figuring out what sort of change is positive change. Change is not intrinsically good, and progress is not inevitable. Our ancestors in Egypt and throughout history have grappled with this same question. Every generation asks itself, what will the journey to the promised land require of me? The prophet Jeremiah, born during a period of prosperity not unlike our own, reminds us to emulate God in all our behavior. Don't simply attain wisdom for its own sake, he says. Use your wisdom to bring about kindness. Use your strength in the pursuit of justice. And with your wealth, seek equity. Moses was our greatest teacher, and he led our people's journey from Egypt. And like Moses, we can look to the promised land and imagine what life there will be like for our descendants. A world completely unlike the Egypt we have known, a world without slavery, idolatry, and injustice. But like Moses, we will not cross the Jordan ourselves. We must labor to bring our children there quickly, while there is still the possibility that they will not pass along to the next generation the failings of our own, the prejudices, the fears, and the inequality. We build that world by how we interact with one another, and our children deserve to inherit that promised land.